The presentation will start in a moment with the entrance of the Lord Mayor's procession. Ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you please to stand if you can? Please welcome the Right Worshipful the Lord Mayor of Liverpool, Councillor Ross Patton, and her consort, Councillor Roy Gladden, the Lord Lieutenant of Merseyside, Dame Lorna Muirhead, Dame Commander of the Royal Victorian Order, and Dame Commander of the Order, the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, and Mr. Ronald Moore, the High Sheriff of Merseyside, Mr. Jim Davis, Officer of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, the Honorary Consul for France, Mr. Philip Daniel, representing the Mayor of Liverpool, Councillor Ian Francis, the Armed Forces Champion, Liverpool City Council, the Chief Executive of Liverpool City Council, Mr. Jed Fitzgerald, and the Rector of Liverpool, the Reverend Dr. Crispin Haley. Ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for the Right Worshipful of the Lord Mayor of Liverpool, Councillor Ross Gladden.
The Order, Nationality, the Regiment, the Honorary Consul of France, and risks that these brave men and women have made and still take every single day to ensure that our world is a much safer one. We owe all those who have served and still serve our country a huge debt of gratitude. It is, of course, very important that we remember those who did not return from conflict, and each year the Court pays its respect at the service of remembrance and dedication held at the Cemetery on St. George's Court, Glasgow. The Lord Mayor has been a great honour to attend so many military-related events during my year in office, and I am delighted to host today's ceremony. It is a fantastic gesture by the French government to acknowledge our brave men from this remarkable generation, and it gives me great pleasure to congratulate all the members of the guests here today. You truly deserve this highest honour. It is also my privilege to present two honorary citizens of honour at the City of Liverpool this afternoon. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now fitting that I now introduce the Rector of Liverpool, the Reverend Dr. Christian Cady, who will provide a prayer for those who did not meet him.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to introduce Lieutenant Colonel Sean McElroy, who will provide the background on the Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur. After a Roman legion with legionnaires.
President of the Republic of France, who was Grand Master of the Order. On the 70th anniversary of D-Day in June 2014, the French President announced that this distinction would be awarded to all British veterans who fought for the liberation of France during the Second World War. Veterans must have taken part in military operations in France between 1944 and 1945. Operation Neptune, Normandy landings, but the landing operation on Tuesday the 6th of June 1944 termed as D-Day. Of the Allied guerrillas in Normandy, in Operation Overlord during World War II, the largest seaborne invasion in history, the operation began of German occupied northwestern Europe and Nazi control and contributed to the Allied victory on the Western Front. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my privilege to read the individual citations, after which may I ask the recipient to come forward for the presentation of the Ordre National de la Région de l'Air by the Honorary French Consul, Mr. Philip Daniel, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France. But before that, can we please pray silence for the Honorary Consul for France, Mr. Philip Daniel.
Lord Mayor, Lord Lieutenant, High Sheriff, Reverend Sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to be here this afternoon. It's an honour to be here representing the French nation to present the highest award to the nation of honour to the soldiers who are here today. I would like to offer my thanks for the hospitality that we've received this afternoon. This is the first time the Town Hall has met in this way, and it's a wonderful place to hold these ceremonies. Thank you very much. I would also like to say thank you to the Lord Lieutenant and the High Sheriff, who have also supported these ceremonies, not only in this room, but in other rooms in this Town Hall, and who also are part of a large number of men and women who perform these civic roles without complaint, with always with generosity and in an eye which is always hospitable. I've done these ceremonies in Preston, Chorley, and in Wallasey, and on every occasion for the support which they have shown. The most important thanks, I think, should go to the recipients of the Nation of Honour, the six men whose names are on the sheet you kind of written came in. I think that they would be the first to say that they are accepting this award on behalf of all those people who took part in the day D-Day landings in 1944. Not only those they came back with, but those they left behind. I feel that their effort contributed to a political achievement at the end of the Second World War, which led to a period of relative peace and a period unlike for which
this afternoon is Captain Timothy Joseph Fitzgerald, 3rd Battalion, the Irish Guards. Captain Timothy Fitzgerald is now 91.
One of the younger ones.
When he enlisted into the Irish Guards to go to war, lying about his age, the recruiting sergeant must have been from the mix and recognised him as a young man with potential and allowed him to enlist only because he was joining the Irish Guards. Captain Fitzgerald saw action in Northern Europe during World War II as a member of the Guards Armoured Division who came ashore at Sword Beach, and the division led the armoured thrust to retake Caen, which was heavily fortified and defended by the German Tiger tanks. Having successfully captured Caen, after bloody fighting, the division pushed through Belgium, meeting stiff resistance and then into Holland in preparation for Operation Market Garden. Arnhem was the next major objective, and the 32nd Armoured Brigade, comprising of the 2nd and 3rd Battalions of the Irish Guards and the 1st Battalion of the Welsh Guards, were ordered to seize the home bank of the River Rhine in preparation for the assault by the 1st UK Airborne, 82nd US Airborne, and the Polish Airborne Divisions. Arnhem saw the loss of many Allied troops, and eventually the bridge was secured and the crossing points established across the River Rhine, and the Allies continued the advance into Germany. After the war, Tim joined the Liverpool Police and served as a constable until he retired at age 55. Captain Fitzgerald was active for many years with the TA and the Army Cadets in the Liverpool and Sefton areas, spending many a weekend at Orkney Training Camp, as well as many camps in the Isle of Man and Scotland. He was also a long-standing committee member of the Irish Guards Association in the north of England. Tim married Pat in 1958 and has five sons, two of whom are living here today. Today, the Honorary Consul of France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de Légion d'honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe.
Having been delayed, the invasion fleet proceeded to Normandy on
on the 5th of June. Both King's battalions landed on D-Day, the 6th of June, the 5th at Sword Beach and the 3rd with the 3rd British Infantry Division and the Liverpool Irish at Juno and the 3rd Canadian Infantry Division. At Sword, as the 3rd Division moved inland, the 5th Kings attempted to neutralise hostile positions and snipers. Under fire, the beach groups collected the wounded, the dead, and located and marked minefields, attempting to maintain organisation and directed vehicles and troops inland. The 5th Kings operated with the beach groups for a further 6 weeks. After taking part in the D-Day landings, Burney was placed in a number of different battalions as he advanced through France. After being injured in Belgium near the German border, he was airlifted back to England to recuperate. After his recuperation, Burney returned to the Royal Army Service Corps and spent time in Egypt and Greece, after which he left the army, returning to Liverpool. In Liverpool, he secured employment in the Automatic Telephone and Electric Company, locally called the Automatic, later PESIC, where he worked until he retired. He has been married for over 60 years to Flo. He has four children, 8 grandchildren, and 4 great-grandchildren. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe. To reinforce the Royal Winnipeg Rifles, who incurred significant B Company areas the late arrival of the tanks exposed the landing infantry to heavy machine gun fire. While under fire, the beach group collected the wounded and the dead, located and marked the minefields, attempted to main organisation, and directed vehicles and troops to land. On the 7th of June, the bomb released by a load of Luftwaffe pilot exploded amongst the anti-tank platoon, killing 15 and badly wounded 7. Michael was a member of that anti-tank platoon. Due to the heavy losses, the battalion had been engaged in protracted operations for weeks. The battalion was put into a suspended animation in August 1944. Michael was assigned to the 1st Battalion of the Royal Ulster Rifles. After fighting through Belgium and Holland and into Germany, the battalion was then sent to Palestine. After the war, Michael returned to Liverpool in 1946 and worked as a scaler in the Liverpool docks. Thereafter, he took an apprenticeship in joinery and moved into the building trade, where he remained until his retirement. Today, the Honorary Consul of France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in the liberation of France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and bringing swiftly to a close the war in Europe. And also, ladies and gentlemen, the Lord Mayor will also present Private Crumby with his honorary citizen of the City of Liverpool as well. Congratulations. This afternoon is Rifleman Desmond James Ryan, 2nd Battalion of the Royal Ulster Rifles. Desmond was born in Liverpool in 1926. He grew up in the area of Vauxhall known as Over the Bridge and the Miriam Road in Anfield near Liverpool Football Ground. Growing up in this area was quite difficult, for Desmond was a staunch entertainer. During the Second World War, Desmond, as a young teenager, volunteered for the Home Guard before enlisting into the 2nd Battalion of Royal Ulster Rifles as a rifleman in 1944. The battalion, part of the 3rd Infantry Division, landed at Sword Beach on the 6th of June 1944 and fought in the Battle of Normandy, specifically in Operation Charnwood. On D-Day the 6th of June, Caen was an objective for the 3rd British Infantry Division and maintained the focal point for a series of battles battles throughout June, July and into August. The battle did not go as planned for the Allies, instead dragging on for 2 months because the German forces devoted most of its reserve to holding Conyngham, particularly their armoured divisions. As a result, German forces facing the American invasion thrust further west were spread thin, relying on the rough terrain of the backcountry to slow down the American advance of the Operation Cobra. With so many German divisions held up defending Conyngham, the American forces were eventually able to break through to the south and east, threatening to encircle the German forces in Normandy from behind. The 2nd Battalion, the Royal Ulster Rifles, were the first British troops to enter the city of Conyngham, which had previously seen bitter fighting in the British attempt to capture it. He served in France, Belgium and Germany from 1944 until the end of the war, with responsibilities concerned with logistics and supplying ammunition for the front. At one point, with just 5 other soldiers, he oversaw a camp of 600 displaced persons, mainly Russians. He continued to serve in Palestine until he was discharged from the army in 1948. Post-war, he married the prettiest girl in Liverpool, Helen, and they had 2 daughters and 4 grandchildren. He worked as a maintenance engineer at the Liverpool Warehousing and for the Ford Motor Company, with several jobs in between, including installing the heating and the engineering in the Metropolitan Cathedral of Christ the King and delivering water wine to priests and monasteries all over the country. He spends his time with his family and following the adventures of the mighty Hughes. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its people, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe. Operation Market Garden, which was between the 17th and 20th. south of Hamburg. Richard remained in Hamburg when war in Europe ended and served in the Army of Occupation until September 1946. After discharge, he completed a heating and ventilation engineering apprenticeship in 1948. Career highlights: chief engineer at Martin's Bank, Liverpool, and the senior clerk of works at Lancashire County Council after taking retirement in 1986. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its people from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe.
Sadly died at a young age. They had two children, Maureen and Paul. On his
his 90th birthday, Stephen did a tandem parachute jump in aid of the Alder Hey Children's Charity Hospital, raising £2,500. Stephen has returned to Normandy with other World War II veterans to remember those who fell on a foreign field during their duty defending country. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its people, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its people from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe. Thank you and have a safe journey.